So as you all know, my name is Dr. Jay Madaan, and more than talking about myself, today I'm here to talk about you. You know, a lot of people ask me that, does destiny really exist? Then what about all the hard work that we do? Well, hard work is very important, but why you were born at a particular day, or at a particular time, in a particular family? What if you were born at a neighbor's house? Would your life would have been same? So these are the questions we need to ask. I don't tell people believe in destiny. For me, destiny is understanding of your strengths, your weaknesses, and changing them according to you. It is just a little benefit we can all take from our lives. I am here to talk about you, your hand, your strengths, your life. So when we talk about looking at the hand, the major question that people ask is which hand to consider, right or left? Well, the dominant hand that you have, the hand with which you write, you eat, or you do major works, is the hand which belongs to your karmas, as in your conscious mind. This is what you will bring your results in life with. What about the other hand? The other hand is your destiny hand. It is your subconscious mind. It's the non-dormant hand. These are the strengths, or these are the negative qualities that you're born with. But rest depends on you, whether you can enhance them or you can't. Isn't it so surprising that all of us have different handprints? No single hand is similar to the other. No matter you're born in the same family, you're twins. Your horoscope might be same, but your hands are different. It is so surprising that people who are married together, these are a lot of experiments that have been done, people who are living together, the same family, at a certain age, they have similar disturbances on their palm. But the best part is, the lines keep changing. If your mindset is different, if you understand how to play with this energy, you can change it. I'll start with a small story about seven friends. Who are these seven friends? These are the seven planets on your hands. To begin with, there's a beautiful kingdom, a big kingdom of a very, very powerful king. The king is very powerful, very good looking, like sun in our solar system. He's very dominating. He tells everybody, look, I'm stationary, but you come around me. You have work, you need heat, you need light, come around me. I am not going to do anything. So this very powerful king has a beautiful wife, like all kings have beautiful wife. But this beautiful wife is very moody. Sometimes she says, dear, I love you, let's go out for a date. The other moment she says, oh, I'm not feeling good, let's rest at home. So she has a lot of mood swings. She's very emotional. She's very sensitive. Like all queens, she's very imaginative. But King feels this woman is mad. She's not constant. Why is she so fluctuating? So then what happens? King calls for a beautiful dancer in his court to dance, to entertain him. Like we saw in that movie, Baji Rao Mastani. Yeah, you all have seen. So king calls a beautiful courtesan in his court to dance, to entertain him. And he saw this beautiful, stunning lady. Wow, what clothes, what jewelry, beautiful face, stunning, amazing body. He falls in love with her. She is so charismatic, she's so entertaining, she is so, I would say, she's so sophisticated, he falls for her. Her name is Venus. The name of king is sun, and the name of the queen is moon. Then what happens? There's this little princess in the kingdom who's really pampered by king. King calls her, he really pampers her. She feels very powerful, like a small child. We have small kids in the family. How powerful they feel when they are sitting next to the father. But when she's alone, nobody respects her too much. She talks a lot, like little girls too. Her name is Mercury. She's here on your hand. Then, when king is in time of stress, he calls his guru, his teacher, a pope, or a saint from the kingdom. He takes advice from the saint. You know what? Whenever saint comes, even when a guruji comes in our system, the prime minister stands up for him. That's what Jupiter is all about. And you know why Jupiter has been given this finger? When we'll talk about your hand, Jupiter has been assigned this finger. This is the finger of domination. This is the finger of power. When I have to call somebody with authority, I'll say, come here, sit, stand. Why? I, me,
God. So Jupiter is all about ambition. Jupiter is all about wisdom. He's the one whom king seeks opinion from. After that, whenever there's a moment of fight, moment of stress, kings fall as commander in chief. His name is Mars. Mars is very powerful. He's very confident. He takes care of the army. He takes care of everything. But you know what? This man has a split personality. Sometimes he's so good to king, he wants to handle everything. And sometimes he's so aggressive, he wants to overpower everything. So Mars is a split personality. And to handle everything else, there is this supervisor, Ramu Kaka, in the family. Now what this supervisor, the head servant, does, he takes care of everything. Well, there's a party in the house, he'll take care of flowers, he'll do the little detailing in the house. He will take care of small, small things. He's very focused. He's very disciplined. He has to be, otherwise he'll lose his job. His name is Saturn. And the best part is, all these seven people, very powerful people, they are here on your hands, they're here on your face, but today we'll talk about your hand. What do they represent? How do you understand? A lot of people I've seen, you know, boys and girls, they, you know, at your age especially, they hold each other's hand and try and read their palms. But I assure you, after 10 minutes from now, whenever you'll touch somebody's hands, even if it's for flirting, you'll be able to make sense to them. You'll be able to tell so much about them. So are we all ready? So here we come, and I talk about these seven friends. Their hair on your palm. Whenever we have to do a good auspicious thing, or when it's about your engagement ring, you use this finger. This is called finger of sun. So whenever we apply a sindoor or tilak or anything in our culture or any sort of puja, this finger is used. It's an auspicious finger. This finger belongs to sun. And just the area below this is called mount of sun. If this area is protruded in your hand, if you look at your hand, and if this area is, you know, it's well shaped, it has a shape, that means you're very creative. You're going to be very popular. Popularity is what attracts you. Nothing can stop you from being famous. Well, if you don't have it, don't feel sad, because once I'm done with this, I'll tell you how to shape up your hands. You can create what you want. Somebody sitting up there is not a sadist. He wants to give you what you want, but you have to work hard for it, and I'll talk about it as well. So this is about sun. When you look at somebody's hand, see which area is really popping out. This is the strength of the person. And the area which is little suppressed is the weakness of the person. They can enhance if they want. So this is about your creativity, your fame, your power, your authority, like sun in the solar system. Then we talk about the queen. The queen is moon. Moon is your imagination. Moon is your emotion. Like moon, our mood also changes. Sometimes it's full, sometimes there's no moon, sometimes you feel so giddy. This area in your hand tells your imagination, your poetry, your sense of emotion. If somebody has this part as very, very protruding part, they're very emotional people. If this is suppressed, they're very practical people. Now we talk about the princess. The princess is Mercury. Mercury is this. You remember when we were kids, I used to do that like a naughty child. Whenever I used to study in class, not as obedient as you people are sitting, I used to always stand up in the class and say, may I use the washroom? May I use the washroom? Ma'am, washroom, washroom. So this finger has been, you know, talked about communicating something which is inside. This is the finger of Mercury. This is your communication. People who have long little fingers are very good orators. They're born orators. They can somehow influence others. If this finger is small or this mount is not protruding, don't worry, we'll talk about it. But this is about your business skills, your communication, your authority of earning money through the way you talk, is represented by this area and your finger. How can I forget talking about that beautiful lady who actually made king fall for her? Venus. Venus is this part of your hand. Venus is about beauty. Venus is about luxury. Venus is about all the pleasures in life, which actually are good for nothing. Like air conditioner is Venus. Well, it gives you air, it consumes more electricity, it is not good for your skin, not good for your bones, but you can't live without it. Well, that's what Venus is all about. So if this part in your hand really has a big dominant shape, reflects that your Venus is very strong, you will have all the luxuries in life. In case it is not, we will talk about it. After that comes the wisdom, Jupiter, almighty. If this part in your finger, this mount, if it's protruding, you can see, if it has a prominent shape, that means you are born to get wisdom in life. Your administration is wow. People will listen to you whenever you'll talk to them. Then I talk about Mars, who has split personality. It is divided into two parts. This area, just next to your thumb, is good Mars. If you have this area as strong area, it's the skin, the flesh you can feel, it means you're a confident person. If this area is strong, it's called negative Mars. That means you're cunning. You can be aggressive as well. And you can harm others by being a little aggressive. If both the areas are there, then you know how to balance yourself. And last but not the least, Saturn, it's here. So the middle finger is tallest, yet it remains amongst everything else. Saturn, if this area is too strong, that means you'll start remaining aloof. You know, if servant in the house becomes too dominating, nobody would want to keep him. If this area is too suppressed, I mean, there's nothing over it, it makes you lose your focus. You're not concentrated. A lot of kids, you see, if this area doesn't exist for them, they're not at all focused in studies, and especially engineers, people like you, should have this area because you just get into something and then derive something out of it. You need a lot of focus. So these seven friends on your hand, how to enhance them? Sun, if you don't have this mount and you really want to be famous in life, you really want to do something, then you must sit in sunlight, opening your palms and feel sun rays falling on this part of your hand. Trust me, nothing in this life is above your mind. You should know how to use it. Concentrate the sun rays on this area. Within 6 months, you can see this mount developing. There are other shortcuts also. The color of the sun is orangish, goldenish. You know, that's the glowing sun. You can add that color, a natural color, at this part of your hand to be more famous. If you want more wisdom in life, Jupiter naturally in the solar system has prominent yellow color. You can use natural yellow saffron or turmeric towards this part of your finger in case you feel insights don't come to you. You are not intuitive enough. If you feel you're married or your girlfriend doesn't treat you well, you don't have pleasures in life, enhance your Venus. For this, you need to apply a fragrance, rose, on this part to enhance luxuries and pleasure of your life. It does something to your subconscious mind where you feel more relaxed, you feel more enhanced, you're more in love. That is why rose has been associated with love. Why not lilies? Why not people give lilies on Valentine's Day? Well, it's the most expensive flower. But still, because rose is all about love. If you want to enhance your Mars, you need to work on your confidence. You need to see right things. You need to think positive. You need to play a lot with red color. Red color brings a lot of energy in your system. It makes you feel very powerful. If somebody is just walking in red, you can't avoid noticing them. If you want to be noticed, if you feel your confidence is not great, try and wear red. It does something to your system that works more on your blood circulation. It makes you feel more confident. If you feel you can't impress people by the way you talk, people don't believe when you talk, or if you want to earn through your speech, you need to enhance your Mercury. The color of Mercury is green. Having leafy vegetables does really good for your system. Have a lot of greens in your system. Being a vegan also helps you to develop better speech. So try and add a lot of green leafy things, raw green leafy things in your diet. If you want to be more imaginative, you want more emotional control, you want to handle your emotions more wisely, you need to do something with your moon. Don't waste water. Moon is water. it represents water in our life. A lot of people, you know, especially when I was traveling today also to the flight, a lot of people drink half water, throw half. Don't do that. If you can conserve water, trust me, your moon can enhance in a very, very natural way. The way we maintain natural, the way we care about natural things, the way we care about our environment, everything in our lives become balanced because you think beyond yourself. If you want to enhance your Saturn, you want to be more focused in life, try and practice putting a thread in a needle at least 20 times a day, because that is how you tell your mind to focus, to be straight, to remain concentrated. These are little practices that you can do and change a lot about your hand, change a lot about your life. I hope you enjoy the 7 friends on your hands and try and take maximum benefit out of you. Thank you for being so patient and listening to me. Thank you.